Welcome back to another free training video from ITFreeTraining. In this video, I will look at two different troubleshooting techniques that can be used with device drivers. The first is last known good configuration, and the second is device driver rollback. Last known good configuration works by storing a working set of your configuration that you can revert back to if your system fails to boot after a system change. The configuration of your computer is stored in the registry under HKLM System, CurrentControlSet. When you install a device driver or make a configuration change, the change is made in the CurrentControlSet. The problem is that the change may not take effect until you reboot your computer. When the computer reboots, sometimes a change can cause the computer to crash or freeze on boot. To allow you to recover from this and boot your system, Windows does the following. When Windows starts up and the user successfully logs into Windows, Windows assumes that the current configuration must be working. Windows will then copy this configuration to a backup configuration set. Let's have a look at what happens when a buggy device driver is installed that requires a reboot and crashes the computer on startup. When the driver is installed, the configuration for that driver will be put into the CurrentControlSet. When the computer is rebooted, the CurrentControlSet contains the buggy driver and the computer will fail to boot. When this occurs, you want to revert back to the working backup control set. To do this, during system boot up, press F8 and select the option Last Known Good Configuration. This will boot the system using the backup configuration that was saved the last time the computer was started and the user successfully logged in. Using the backup configuration, you can hopefully get your computer booting again without the buggy device driver crashing the system. In some cases, you may install a buggy device driver, but were able to reboot the computer and log in. When this occurs, the backup control set will also contain the buggy device driver, and thus you can't use the last known configuration to undo the changes. Windows has a device driver rollback feature, which is available assuming you can boot the computer and log in. Using this feature, you can roll back a device driver, returning the system back to what was present before the device driver was installed. This will be either the previous device driver or no device driver in the system. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to have a look at how to use these two features. I will first demonstrate how last known good configuration works. To do this, first of all, open Device Manager from the Start menu. Notice in Device Manager that there is a missing device. I will install a device driver by right-clicking the device, selecting Update Driver, and then browsing to the files for this device driver. Now that the device driver has been installed, I will reboot the computer. Sometimes when you install a device driver, the computer will blue screen when the computer starts up. If you can't log into the computer, it makes it difficult to remove the problematic device driver. Remember that last known good configuration does not copy the current configuration until you log in. Currently, I have not logged in, so the changes that I made when installing the device driver have not been saved to last known good configuration. Why? Well, until I log in, Windows will assume this configuration has not proven itself to be stable. To demonstrate how to use last known configuration, I will simulate a driver problem by manually causing a blue screen like this. If you are curious how to do this, see the description for this video for more information. The system will now reboot. After the BIOS screen and just before Windows starts up, press the F8 key. This will display the boot options. It is easy to miss the timing of this, so you have to be quick. There are a lot of troubleshooting settings on this screen. The one that we are interested in is last known good configuration. If I select this and let the computer boot up, Windows will use a configuration that it knows was used previously to boot the computer and allowed the user to log in. To demonstrate this, once the computer has started up and I have logged back in, I will once again open Device Manager. Notice in Device Manager that the device driver that I installed previously has been removed and no driver is currently installed. You can see how last known good configuration can quickly recover the system from a recently installed device driver that is causing your system to crash on boot, and you can get back to, well, the computer blue screened again, so I guess some more troubleshooting is required. Sometimes a buggy device driver is very difficult to troubleshoot. A buggy device driver may cause a blue screen to occur very randomly, and you may not know what is causing it. A lot of the time, upgrading to the latest device driver will fix these problems, but sometimes an earlier version of the device driver may prove to be more reliable. Once the computer has rebooted and I have logged back in, I will once again open Device Manager from the Start menu. The last device driver I installed was the video driver. To roll back the device driver to the previous version, right-click the device driver and select the properties for the device driver. On the Driver tab, press the button Roll Back Driver, and the current device driver will be removed and the old device driver reinstalled. Once I confirm this is what I want to do and then close the properties for the device driver, you will notice that the display adapter device driver has changed back to standard VGA graphics adapter. In most cases, upgrading a device driver to a newer version will be more stable than keeping an older device driver. In the rare case the newer device driver causes more problems, remember the rollback device driver option will quickly remove the device driver and return you back to the previous device driver. Unlike last known good configuration, this can be done at any time and is not affected by how many times you log in to the system. Well, that's it for the free Windows 7 course from ITFreeTraining. If you have watched all the videos in this free course for Windows 7, I would like to thank you for taking the time to watch. All of our videos are free on YouTube, and only by you watching these videos can we keep doing what we are doing. If you like this course, please feel free to look at our other free courses like Active Directory and Application Infrastructure for Windows Server 2008 R2. For the last time in this Windows 7 training course, thanks for watching.